In this video, let's see another numerical problem which was asked in the IIT JEE previous year examination. The year was 1983. The marks for which it was asked were 2 marks. The question says, let fx is equal to x square upon 2, 2x square minus 3x plus 3 by 2. X square upon 2 lies between 0 to 1 such that 0 is included, 1 is not. And here it lies between 1 to 2, 1 and 2 both are included. Discuss the continuity of f, f dash, f double dash on 0 to 2. So in one instance, in one go, when somebody sees this function and reads till here, discuss continuity. So that means everybody will start discussing the continuity, finding LHL, RHL. But if you do not read the question full, you will not come to understand that this question is again a hybrid question as per the tradition and customs of IIT JEE, which always involve 2-3 concepts in one question, right? So it has f, that means the function, f dash means the first order derivative, f double dash means the second order derivative. So it is based on continuity, it is based on differentiation, it is based on higher order derivatives. So you need to know almost everything in order to solve this question, right? So let's write the heading as solution. We are going to start with the solution. So it is fx is equal to something given to us. Let's first discuss about this fx only because it says continuity of f. So continuity of f. So continuity of f means continuity of the function as such as it is what is given to us. That is about continuity of f, the first thing. And continuity of f, see 0 and 2 are the outside things. 1 is included. Here 1, x is less than 1, here x is greater than. So we have to basically check the continuity at 1 only. Because at 0 and 2 there is no problem. In the interval 0 to 2 given f on 0 to 2, you see here, we are bothered about 1 because rest everything is fine. So continuity of f should be there. What about at f is equal to 1? Let's see LHL at x is equal to 1. What is LHL at x is equal to 1? Means the left hand limit at x is equal to 1. Here if I have to check directly because it is separated, it is bifurcated function, directly put 1. So LHL gives me 1 by 2. What about RHL at x is equal to 1? RHL at x is equal to 1, directly put 1. So it is 2 minus 3 plus 3 by 2. So what is it? Minus 1 plus 3 by 2. What is it? 1 by 2. So that means what? And what about the function value at 1? So f of 1 is also 1 by 2 because 1 is there. You put it here, directly you will get 1 by 2. So you have LHL is equal to RHL is equal to value of the function. So I say that f is continuous, f is continuous at or on this time, because we checked for 1, but we know that for 0 and 2 and other range it's already continuous. So on 0 to 2 included both. So that's done. But the question is not complete, it's a subjective question, analytical one. F dash also needs to be taken into consideration. A separate line would work well. I write continuity of f dash as the heading now. Continuity of f dash is the heading. If continuity of f dash is the heading, I have to take into consideration f dash. For that I need to actually differentiate. So what is f dash x? Differentiation, x square upon 2, that makes it 2x upon 2, which is x. Interval same, 0 to 1, and such that whatever is included remains as it is. Next here it becomes 4x because 2 multiplied by 2x makes it 4x, and then it is minus 3, 3 by 2 constant, leave it in case of differentiation. 1 to 2, see what is included, do not change it. You have to check now the continuity of f dash at again x is equal to 1. So what about LHL at x is equal to 1? What about RHL at x is equal to 1? That you have to check, right? LHL at x is equal to 1 means here. When you put the value 1, you get 1. So the answer is 1. What about here, the RHL? Put it in 4x minus 3. 4 into 1 minus 3, 4 minus 3 makes it 1. And what about the value? F of 1 is again that only, which is equal to f of 1. So again I say LHL is equal to RHL is equal to f of 1. So what happens? So even f dash is continuous at x is equal to 1, and so it is continuous on the whole interval 0 to 2, including everything. Last but not the least is our concern for f double dash. That means the second order derivative. If I name this whole thing as equation 1, if I name it as equation 2, now I have to start with differentiating the 2 again to get the second order derivative. So for f double dash x means you have to differentiate 2. So differentiation of x becomes 1. Here differentiation of 4x minus 3 gives me 4, because with respect to the variable x, minus 3 has no existence in case of differentiation. So again it is 0 to 1, right? And again here it is 1 to 2. Let's talk about the LHL at x is equal to 1. Let's again talk about the RHL at x is equal to 1. And let's talk whether they are equal or not. At x is equal to 1, the left hand limit gives me 1. It gives me 1. At RHL, x greater than equal to 1, it gives me 4. So is LHL equal to RHL? This time, no. Because 1 and 4 are not equal. So I say that my f double dash is not continuous on whole of 0 to 2. Actually, it is not continuous on 1. It is not continuous at 1. So, it is continuous where? So, it is continuous on 0 to 2, 1 excluded. This is how you write it. Let me repeat what I did. We actually check the continuity of f, then f dash, and then continuity of f double dash. You can make the heading yourself, not an issue. Now, LHL and RHL and the value of the function, all three should be equal in order to check for continuity. When continuity was only for the function, directly you can check it. When it was for the first order derivative, first take the first order derivative by differentiating 1 with respect to x, and then check it. When the continuity was for the second order derivative, differentiate 2 in order to get the second order derivative, and then check for the continuity.